Go. Hey guys, and welcome to Geared On For What? Today, I have a gear ratio that's way beyond stupid. This gear ratio is just useless. It's incredible. I'm gonna start this out with some interesting facts on this gearbox, and then we're gonna head out to the shop with a thermal camera and spin this thing up with a drill, a die grinder, maybe a Dremel tool, whatever we can find. To try to keep this thing from completely melting while it's running, I'm going to be using some lubrication for the gearboxes, rather. I'll also be keeping them cool with a can of air duster held upside down, spraying some nice cool stuff on them. So I'm just going to go ahead and hook this drill up to here.
Wait, what?
What?
What are you doing?
What's wrong?
We're supposed to do that at the shop.
Oh, right.
We're going to use a really fast, a Dremel or something.
Well, who put you in charge?
It was your idea.
Oh, well, whatever. Let's talk about facts instead. For those of you familiar with my work in designing 3D printable gearboxes, you'll recognize this 1,379:1 gearbox. And you may notice that I intentionally designed this gearbox so you can mount them on a channel in series. And the resulting gear ratio is equal to 1,379 to the exponent of however many gearboxes are in series. So here I have four of these gearboxes. They're all identical except for this one has a fancy handle on the output. And the resulting ratio from this arrangement of gearboxes is 3.6 trillion to 1, or 3,616,238,492,881 to 1, or 3.6 trillion rotations of this sun gear on this is the input side to achieve one rotation of this output, which is this gear. So this whole thing would be rotating back and forth to that would be the output. Now you may be wondering, how is this last gearbox going to be able to make a full rotation with this handle attached to it? Well, the answer is simple. It won't, and here's why. If the goal is to turn the output of this arrangement one full rotation using a drill, assuming the speed of about 1200 RPM on the input sun gear, then I would only have to spin this gearbox for 50 billion hours. That's 2 billion days, or 5,733 years. Just to make one full turn. That's 16 years per degree of movement. So let's set up a hypothetical situation in a world where friction, entropy, material strength, and all of the other unfortunate realities that we live with on a day-to-day basis are completely non-existent. If I set up a hamster wheel on the input of this sun gear that was 1 inch in diameter and trained an ant to run around on the inside of it, wrapping a rope around this output, which is about 3 inches in diameter, would yield a pulling force of about 6,000 metric tons. That's about what you would need to lift up 439 fully loaded Boeing 747s, or about 50,000 Donald Trumps. So let's talk about the test. For your reference, the output of each gearbox is marked with gray paint, and the input of the next gearbox is connected to the output ring before it. So for example, this is the input for the first gearbox, but the input for this gearbox is the output for the first one. All of these rings here, the red, the yellow, the blue, and the other red ring are all completely stationary, ideally, if they stay there. So to test this gearbox, I'll be spinning with a die grinder, possibly a Dremel tool, depending on what kind of attachment methods I have available. On to lubrication. For lubrication, my main concern is avoiding anything that will cause the plastic to dissolve, so logically my first thought was to use soap. I mean, soap is really slippery and you would think that it would work really well and it's not likely to attack the plastic. But after a Google search, I got sidetracked and I never really completed my research. So for today, I think we're going to be using 3-in-1 oil. For cooling, it was a complete toss-up between an upside-down air duster can and water. I chose the air duster can because of its low electrical conductivity. Do we have a Dremel tool here?
I don't know, let's go check the shop.
Yeah, I bet there's one at the shop. Let's go to the shop. So we're going to put some 3-in-1 oil in these gearboxes so that they don't wear out, because magic. And just load them up, you know. This one isn't even going to turn, but I'm going to put some 3-in-1 oil in it anyways. Did I give it away? Oops. And then air duster. Magic. And let's start up the Dremel. Ready? 3, 2, 1. So, spinning gearbox, attempt number 3. Ready, set, go. Fix that now.
Yep. I saw a bright red ring, and then it,
what happened?
I think, the joint where the Dremel tool touches the plastic under the table.
So what happened here, Dylan?
Oh. First things first, the Dremel cut into the sun gear.
Oh, yeah, that's right. It did peel away the sun gear a little bit.
So we didn't have that contact to drive it anymore. You used electrical tape to combine it again.
Being an electrician, it just came naturally.
I don't know if that was the best idea. No matter which way you spun it, there was still enough force for this to peel apart on its own.
Yeah, I thought that I had wrapped it the wrong way, but I had wrapped it the right way. It just still peeled it off.
That came off way too easy.
Yeah, I think it had some lube in it. Oops.
Oh, well. It got to the point we got a few degrees of motion out of the second output. But if it's going to take 16 years to get 1 degree out of this last one, I don't think we're going to stick around for that. I have got work in the morning.
Yeah, I don't, but I think you're right. Being this gearbox never moved, I don't see any way this one could have. And this one only moved at least 2 Donald Trumps, maybe 3, somewhere in there. This one moved, I'm not sure.
Whatever, let's go home.
If you guys want to see a really cool video where I take this gearbox and I lift up an anvil with it, there's a link in the description. You should really check it out because it's awesome.
Watch my other videos!
Hey, thanks for watching.